All right, in this video, we're going to talk about the basics of App Inventor. And once you log into your App Inventor 2 account, you should be taken to a projects page that looks similar to this. You'll have all your projects listed, or no projects if you haven't started any. And then to start a new project, there's a button in the top left. If we type our project name, we will be told that we're not allowed to put spaces in our project, so we'll simply eliminate the space for our project and then click OK. Usually it will load automatically. Other times you will have to click the project and it'll open the project up. So now we have on our left side a interface, a bunch of components such as user interface, the layout, media, drawing and animation, sensors, and various other categories. Right, so we're going to be doing mobile development, so we have a bunch of sensors we'll get to in later projects. For now, we're going to stick with the basic user interface and media components when describing. Right, so and then on our right side we see our components list, things that we've dragged onto our view. Right, so right now we only have screen, and then we have properties for each of those components, or the selected component. For screen, we have several different properties that are useful. Our app name, which can contain spaces, and that's the application name that shows up in your app list or app drawer. And then we have our icon, which we can set to an image. It's best to use a square image, right? Something with the width and the height is the same, right? And then we have our screen orientation. We can pick our orientation, either landscape or portrait. Or let the sensor switch it, or let the user switch it, so on and so forth. And then we can have our status bar show up or not. Our status bar is the one with the battery and such. And then we have our title, which is screen one currently, which we often set to the name of the screen we're on, or if we only have one screen, sometimes we set it to the name of the app. Also, we could just make it invisible completely, so when we launch the app, this will just disappear, and all that will be there is the full screen application. And we won't see the title bar. So that is the properties. So in order to look at some of the components, we would drag them onto our viewer. So we have text button, label, or maybe some sound. So we see that we have a button and a label here. All three of our components are under screen one. But then the sound is invisible, so it shows up down here, right? And then we can go through and look at any of the properties of the components. And they have different properties based on the type of component they are, right? Sound only has minimum playtime, minimum interval that it can be played. And then a source, the sound file, right? And we also can delete a component or rename it. And renaming is important because if you have five buttons, you need to know which button is which. When you're referring to button one, does that one control the color or the size or something different? So we might say button color or button red or button blue if it's different colors for different buttons. Okay, so those are the basic components and design view that we have in App Inventor, and in later videos we'll cover the blocks.